STARLAB stands for Simulated Teaching and Research Laboratory, and it is aimed at actually involving the students in making the theories come alive. Today is really about consolidating your learning. Today is really about your thinking about the issues. Our initial process was to develop a trading room. It was the first established in a university in Australia.
The STARLAB was started some 25 years ago, and it's been an integral part of the curriculum here in banking and finance at Monash University for all those years. The software packages that are used confront students with real life scenarios, both in financial markets and in corporate decision making, capital budgeting and so forth.
So what the STARLAB does is it really allows you to take the knowledge and the theory that you've learned throughout your degree and then weave it into a very practical experience.
The key skills that the students will get from STARLAB will be transactional trading and managing a position. Secondly, they would be connecting economic information and aggregates to market outcomes. And thirdly, teamwork and collaboration.
Every semester, each team of about three students, sometimes maybe four, is designated a bank. So it really is like a real life simulation of, you know, whatever is happening in the economy.
So you arrive in the class and then trading starts fairly quickly, and then who knows what will happen. It's kind of, you have a plan and then pretty quickly that will go out the window. We had everything from fire sales, market crashes, to optimism and you know, things surging, to just kind of calm seas and calm sailing. So it's always interesting, you never really know what to expect. You do have some expectations when you walk in there, but things always change very quickly. The competitive element as well is also huge.
The ability to be able to make quick decisions, synthesise information, analyse important information, and then change a position accordingly is quite an important skill to develop.
Okay, now what I want you to do is I want the Aussie dollar going down to 90 cents in 50 pip movements. Boom, bang, 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 I need noise. There's always surprises occurring in STARLAB. Sometimes the surprises are introduced by the teaching faculty. Quite often the surprises are introduced by the students themselves.
In the STARLAB, you're going to learn about risk.
When taking risks and actually losing, it really forces you to learn.
Conservative people can take risk, provided they know how to manage it.
STARLAB is a great example of a strong connection with industry and a strong recognition that industry needs a simulated trading environment to help to give students this experience.
We see the STARLAB as being integral to a strategy for our department to become industry relevant and to have input from industry groups into our curriculum.
We bring industry professionals in to actually talk to students about the problems they might have created and to actually talk about how they might resolve those issues. When we look at our graduates now, they could be working anywhere in the world. It's one of the reasons why graduate attributes and becoming an international citizen is so important.
I think STARLAB being a hands-on unit, it's really allowed me to pick up some really good soft skills.
There's such a variety of roles out there, and I think STARLAB just gives you a taste.
So it really helps you learn more about what it will be like working in the future, because as opposed to just learning from historical data or learning from a textbook, everything will be current news and everything will be affecting the current economies.
All of their decisions are theirs. All of the mistakes are theirs. All of the fun is theirs. Our role is in actual fact to empower them to learn and take responsibility for their own learning. And that's why the facility really works.